Here.
Mr. Palmer?
Here.
Dr. George?
Here.
Dr. Lachlan?
Here. Now it's time for hearing of visitor part one, where if you wish to speak before, you can put in your name and address and speak anything on the agenda. And move to the adoption of resolution number 136 for the minutes. The motion is second. Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Pass the minutes.
At this point, I'd like to introduce Joe Zupanic, and hopefully I pronounced that correctly, Mr. Zupanic. He is representing the Pennsylvania School Board Association. He is a member of the 2015 Governing Board, and he's here to recognize some of our members.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Joe Zupanic. As indicated, I'm a member of the Governing Board of the Pennsylvania School Board Association. A little closer to home, I'm a member of the Cannon-Millen School Board and president of the IU1 Board of Directors. The reason I came to come before you tonight is to present two awards for your long and dedicated service to two of your members. Pennsylvania School Board Association since 1983 has made it a habit to come and to recognize school directors for their years of service in four-year increments after they reach 8 years of service. So 8, 12, 16, 20 years of service. And the School Board Association wants to make sure it gets out and thanks. As we all know, our band of volunteers to make sure that we keep lights on and keep our kids educated in the best way possible. You know, one of the things about being a school board member is we know is that the volunteer position, so all the news we're hearing out of Harrisburg today, 167 without a state budget, is that they're going to double school board pay. Fortunately, that's revenue neutral for the state. I always say that the state and the school board members get paid in frustration sometimes. But to get on to it, what I wanted to do tonight is recognize two of your members on behalf of the School Board Association. Nathan Mames, our executive director, William Pop, our president. And tonight it's my pleasure to present first a certificate of service for 16 years of service to Dr. Michael Zorch. But I have to be honest with certificates of years of service, they wouldn't send me all the way out. Okay. The reason why I'm out here tonight is because after reaching 24 years of service, the Pennsylvania School Board Association presents a plaque for 24 years or more of service. This current year, I've passed out plaques for 40 years of service, 32 years of service, but tonight I come to recognize the main for 24 years, the Greater Latrobe Area School District.
Off the elementary schools, Mountain View will have a Santa shop.
had a Santa shop that was held from November 30th to December 5th that was coordinated by the PTO. On December 5th, there was a breakfast with Santa coordinated by the Mountain View Elementary School's sixth grade leadership team. On December 11th, there was a family cookie exchange and movie night coordinated by the PTO. The kindergarten holiday concert is this Thursday for students and Friday for parents. Moving on to LES, the student council is sponsoring a pajama drive through December 18th. Student council is also ringing the Salvation Army bell at Latrobe Shop and Save on December 18th. Holiday music concerts for grades K through 4 for parents and guests are December 21st during the day. Students in grades K through 4 will sing for the student body on December 22nd, and then the school will finish the assembly with the holiday sing-along. For Bagley, Ms. Horatio didn't want to be completely redundant, but she said that the holiday concerts will be coming up as well, and that the kids are very excited for Santa, as am I, so. On to Carly.
Where does she get it?
Sounds like a convertible to me.
Well, at the junior high, jazz band auditions were held on December 9th. The holiday dance semi-formal with over 300 students in attendance. And the 2015 food drive had a record total of 6,840 items. They beat last year's record by 492. Up at the senior high, the winter concert for band and chorus will be held in school on the 22nd and will be open for the public on the 16th. The chamber choir will also be singing at the Rotary Club also tomorrow. Then the holiday student council, we had a holiday door competition. So we challenged our teachers to motivate our students to decorate the outside of their doors. And our winner was Mrs. Wealthy, a Spanish teacher, with her bone cup Spanish snowman. I wish I had a picture to show you guys. It was fantastic. And student council also did a wish week. So what we did was we had students pay $2 to put a wish in, like donuts for homeroom, and we're donating the money to the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Toys for Tots also had a record year with 300 toys and 2 bikes collected. I don't know who donated them, but it's a lot of money and time donated for that. The Satan's Dance puts the girls in the hot seat and forces them to ask guys to the dance and helps fundraise money to bring down the cost of prom. And I'd also like to shine a little light on our winter sports teams with guys basketball 4-0, girls basketball 3-2, but 2-0 in the section. Wrestling and swimming only had one meet so far, but they are both undefeated. And that concludes the student report.
Thank you very much. Next on the agenda is one of the things I look forward to every year. Love getting to see our students perform. And this is her in the back. We'll see you there on the other side in 1 minute. I know, she's like
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thank you.
Yes, very much.
We're ready. We're ready, Mrs. Thurman. Thank you.
So I want to introduce you guys to the Greater Latrobe Senior High School Chamber Choir. This ensemble rehearses every single day for about 45 minutes. They are an ensemble that easily travels throughout the community and in Pittsburgh, and, you know, later this year we'll be going to Philadelphia. And they're a really, really talented group of folks, and we have five songs that we want to share with you this evening, which will hopefully be a perfect way to introduce our holiday concert that is tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. here in the auditorium, and we hope to see many of you there. It's going to be a great family event, and it's just a perfect way to kick off the holidays. So with that being said, we are going to start with Up on the House.
Up on the housetop,
up on the housetop,
up on the housetop,
is that Santa Claus?
Yes, it's Santa Claus.
Oh, up on the housetop, bring your paws, out jumps good old Santa Claus, down through the chimney with lots of toys, all for the little ones' Christmas joys.
Thank you.
thought. We got into a drifted rain and we got upset. Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Now the ground is white, go it while you're young. Take the girls tonight and sing the sleighing song. Just get up off their mat to 40-40 speed. And they jump to an open sleigh, but you'll take the lead. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
So this next piece is titled Deck the Halls in 7/8. Some of you may have a musical background, and some of you may not, but 7/8 refers to the time signature that this piece is written in, and it's going to feel a little jazzier than your traditional Deck the Halls. And when we first read through it, we were a little terrified for sure, but we eventually perfected it, and I hope you enjoyed it.
so you weren't going to get out of here without it.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much. Take care.
I will move for adoption of resolution number 128 to approve the in-school home health aid nursing services. Second. Moved in second. Any comments or questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously. Thank you. Your curriculum committee meeting minutes of our meeting on November 17th are attached. The next curriculum committee meeting is Tuesday, February the 9th, 5:30 p.m. here in the school. That's all. Thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Dane. Finance, Mrs. Ellis?
Thank you. I'm going to combine resolution number 129, approval of the treasurer's report, with resolution 130, approving the payment of bills, and move for their adoption.
Second.
Moved in second. Any questions? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
I move for adoption of resolution number 131. This title is self-explanatory, to approve the Act One resolution not to raise taxes above the index.
Second. Moved in second. Any comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
I move for adoption of resolution number 132, to approve the fund balance transfer of $1 million from the general fund unassigned fund balance to the restricted fund for capital project.
Second.
Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
And following that resolution, to move for adoption of resolution number 133, approving the intent to reimburse ourselves from the proceeds of the tax exempt obligation. Once we receive that, we'll put the money back.
Second. Moved in second. Any comments or questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
Thank you. And the next finance committee meeting will happen on Wednesday at 10 a.m., Wednesday, January 6th at 10 a.m. at the admin building. Thank you.
Mrs. Ellis, property is closed, Mr. Ellis?
Thank you. I'd like to move for approval of resolution number 134, which is the permission to advertise for 2016-17 general school supply bids.
Second. Any comments or questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
I'd also like to move for adoption of resolution number 135. It's award bid for the spring sports equipment and supply for the 2015.
Second. Moved in second. Any comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
And I'd like to announce that our next meeting will be January 14th. That's a Thursday at 3:30 p.m.
Student activities. I would like to move for the adoption of resolution 136, which is to approve the athletic department insurance at the Mecry High from Seton Health. This term will be January 1st to May 15th of this coming. Second. Been moved in second. Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
That passes unanimously. That's my report. Community relations, Dr. Miller.
Park and Rec meeting tomorrow night. Is that tomorrow?
No, Thursday.
Thursday night. That's all I got.
Thank you. IU, Mrs. Mays? Thank you. The next WIU committee meeting will be Tuesday, January the 26th at 7:30 p.m. in the WIU boardroom. Thank you. EWCTC, Mr. Music?
Thank you. EWCTC Joint Operating Committee meeting minutes are attached to your agenda. I'm sorry, the next meeting is going to be Wednesday, January 27th at the EWCTC.
I'll be there, thank you.
Thank
For those of you that didn't get to the meeting last week, Earl was elected at his first meeting. He's the first president of the county area board.
Oh, yeah. He's your honor. Thank you.
It's a resume stuffer.
Board policy, Mrs. Zeller?
Thank you. I have no report on board policy this evening, but I'd like to add to the presented report that last night was the fundraiser that the kids at EWPTC had for the Make-A-Wish Foundation. And I went to pick up our meals early. Things were a little slow, but I understand from people I call later for Meals on Wheels who were on their way to it or had already come back from it, that it was a well-attended event, and I hope they did well.
Acknowledging Mr. Palmer.
Thank you, Dr. Hoffman. All I have is our next meeting will be Tuesday, January 12th, here at 6 p.m. Thank you.
I'd like to, or ask the board to move on resolution number 137, which is the approval of the resignations that are listed.
So moved.
Second. Moved and seconded. Any comments? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
I'd ask the board to move on resolution number 138, which is the approval of the professional personnel substitute teachers listed.
So moved.
Second. Moved and seconded. Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
And I'd ask the board to move on resolution number 139, which is the approval of the support personnel appointments classified.
So moved. Second. Moved and seconded. Any questions? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
And the last resolution is number 140, which is the approval of a sabbatical leave for Jason Brandt for the second semester of the 2015-16 school year.
So moved. Second. Moved and seconded. Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That passes unanimously.
And just a couple of other things. You should have at your place the PSBA bulletin that we just received for you to review. And I also shared the principles for governance and leadership. And I know Mrs. Elder has maybe some comments to make on this. But everyone has at their place a card which lists the seven principles for governance and leadership. And this is a review. This was voted on at the PSBA conference, and it is suggested strongly that boards review these again because they have been updated and ask the boards to make a resolution to approve these. We would obviously not do this evening, but give you an opportunity to review them and then bring that back in January. Obviously, when you review them, I don't could have a conversation about each of them, but obviously each one of them leads to a highly effective board. So I don't know if there's any comments, Mrs. Elder, if you would like to make them. I know you had spoken to me about this, and right after that we received the packet. So, or if there's any conversation or questions now, but we can certainly discuss it in January as well.
I'd like the board members to look at the way we would look at a new policy. Kind of trying to figure out what the permutations might be, whether you agree with them, whether you really agree with them, whether we ought to take more notice of them as we go through our year and look at our resolution. And I'd also like to comment on the magazine, which I received at home today. It's amazing how much useful information is in one of these magazines. I'm getting a little spoiled by the thing we get every morning and you can read in 5 minutes and you're done. This is deep and a lot of good stuff. And particularly, one of the things that caught my eye was the issue of children's custody awards having to do with where they go to school and how they go to school and who pays for them to go to school. That's all in there and it's very interesting and it's something that we have been interested in as the years have gone by. So So I would recommend both of those to you. And I'd like to ask the principals for government and leadership in January if we can take a look at them and review the whole and then pass them at the regular meeting.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You also have at your place an article that was in the Tribune Review with a picture of Acacia Help on the front. Didn't know if everyone had an opportunity to see it, but it was a very nice article about the artwork and a student who had done an updated version of the DVD or video, whatever you want to call it, of the art in the high school. And they noted Acacia and her dedication to the media production area here at the high school. So I just wanted to give you a copy if you haven't had an opportunity to see it. And you also have an updated list of the committees since the board reorganization at your place, and we will be placing those on the website tomorrow. Also noted is the Christmas concert that Ms. Thurman mentioned before the performance here this evening, as well as the Breakfast of Champions, which is the third day for the month of December. And our board meetings are noted. There are two meetings in January and February, and they do fall on the second and third Tuesdays of those months. That's all I have. Thank you.
Hearing visitors part two. Again, if you have any questions, comments, come forward to the podium and state your name and address. And I move for the adoption of Resolution 141. Under. Second. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you very much.
Was this?